The Nikki Clarke Show, transforming lives one story at a time. If you would like to be a guest or become a part of our live studio audience or even to become a sponsor, just go to www.nikkiclarkenetwork.com.
The energy in the air. Welcome to the Nikki Clarke Show, taped live at La Creole, 810 St. Clair Avenue West. And how is everybody doing tonight?
Great!
Awesome. I love it. Wow. So much has been going on in the news. So let me ask you, what time is it?
Hot Topics!
That's right. It's time for Hot Topics. And Hot Topics are what you find trending in social media, what people are converging at the water cooler and talking about at the office. And joining me in the Hot Topics discussion is the amazing DJ Ron John. Please welcome him.
Everybody.
Awesome.
How you doing?
I'm looking good. You look good. I like your shirt. I live.
This is the station I do a radio show on every Friday. It's called Colors of Rhythm.
Yes.
World music show.
All right.
And it's on iliveradio.com. Spell like the words, radio.com, one word.
Love it.
Okay. 6 to 8 p.m.
All right. So, you think you know some people to get me on your show?
Yeah.
You know somebody?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I know somebody.
We'll work it out. What has everyone been talking about? Cecil the Lion. Did you hear about that? Mm-hmm. Horrendous story.
Yeah.
So Cecil the Lion was lured out of his wildlife reserve in Zimbabwe by the reviled Minnesota-based dentist Walter Palmer some days ago. And Zimbabwe is now calling to extradite the Minnesota dentist. Apparently, the dentist says he didn't know you know, the kind of boundaries and the legislation behind hunting this animal, but how he was captured and how he was shot was horrible. Yeah. What do you think?
Oh, wow. It's loaded in many ways.
Yes.
I mean, there's the hunting aspect of
hunting,
it.
Hunting,
that's one thing.
Yeah.
The rule of it, too, is the fact that the lion was lured out of the area to do it, right? And him not knowing the laws, but then apparently, from what I've heard, is he has a huge collection of different animals.
So this is not his first time.
It's not his first time.
Okay.
Right?
So now, he just got
I'm not
caught
sure what
this
he,
time.
He just got caught,
yeah.
pretty much.
Yeah.
But he did, right? So, hey, all I can say is that it's some hobby of his, but I don't know. It's
you need to switch
not
hobbies.
Not my cup of tea. Definitely
yeah,
not my
yeah,
cup of tea.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Well, did you hear about the dentist? I don't know if he's a dentist, but I think he's a medical practitioner. Mm-hmm. He has a doctor, Walter Palmer, same name in the States. He's getting death threats.
Yeah.
Different doctor, same death threats.
Wow.
Isn't that incredible? So he's like up in arms trying to figure that one out.
Yeah, that's...
That's unfortunate.
Then again, that's another thing altogether,
yeah.
too.
Yeah, you know, mistaken identity.
It's one thing to have an opinion on something, but it's another thing to actually terrorize somebody. It's an innocent person over the top.
Wow. Did you hear about, anybody here have a Beanie Baby? You know the Beanie Baby dolls? I used to collect them. Make some noise if you know what I'm talking about. Yeah. Well, you know, I mean, it's a horrible thing that happened, but what the manufacturer, plush toy manufacturer, Thai Inc., they're the people who make the Beanie Babies, they're actually going to make a Cecil the Lion doll. And all the proceeds will be going to the Wildlife Conservation Research Unit in the States. So that's a good thing. Yeah, so
yeah.
I'm going to get one and support the cause, definitely. So did you hear about the OVO Fest? Drake, you know, he had something going on over the weekend, and there was a man and a woman shot.
Yeah, that was at the after party.
The OVO Fest
happened, if I'm correct, was it at the Molson Amphitheater?
Yeah, I believe
but
so.
But then the after event was at
Musique
at Exhibition Place.
Yeah.
And the incident happened after, but then apparently somebody somehow got their weapon into the club, because apparently one person got shot in. So how did he pass all that security?
I know. Because police officers and security guards.
And security, because I heard it was a highly secured event.
Right.
So either this person found a hole in later on in the evening where they got lax or something like that. But still terrible to happen, given the week that Drake had. It was a really good week for him in the sense that he was accused of something and he responded and sort of finished the beef that he had with
which was like, does everyone know about the Meek Mill, that whole drama that's been going on? Can you just summarize it of us who don't know what's
just
happening?
Just to break it down. So Meek Mill's a hip hop artist out of Philadelphia. And Drake, if those know, he's from here, hip hop artist from Toronto. They worked on a track together on the new album that he has out. And what happened was Meek Mill was sort of upset that Drake didn't push his album or just even tweet something. So he sort of said, well, Drake Ghost wrote, you know, had ghostwriters to write the music that he did with them. And then he kept going on and on and on and on. Yeah. And mind you, put that aside, Meek had the number one album in the country and had one of the most well-known artists in the industry right now, Nicki Minaj, his girlfriend. So you think he'd be a little chill and happy.
Kind of grateful.
Yeah, kind of grateful, but, you know, he wanted to create some drama. And Drake's the kind of guy that people know sort of as laid-back guy and doesn't
do
anything.
The polite Canadian
artist,
right?
Yeah, like a laid-back. But then he promised a track to come at Drake. Drake came up with one track to counter. He didn't do anything, and then Drake hit this back-to-back, and then it just set up a whole internet storm.
Yeah, it was crazy, the frenzy that's been happening.
It was crazy. It was an interesting week in hip-hop in that sense. But the unfortunate thing is, this is that happened this weekend. And according to one note, it had nothing to do with the artist per se.
No relationship.
It's just that, like I said, some of these events will invite knuckleheads to come in, and this is the nonsense that happens. And that's unfortunate.
It is really unfortunate to have that ugly, ugly thing happen. But it's done. Hopefully the drama's done between Drake and Meek.
I hope, and like I said, hip hop's a culture where, you know, it's sort of like, you know, karate. You show your art form and you go and fight your art form, but you keep it there and you don't take it.
Take it elsewhere.
Take it elsewhere.
Yeah.
Okay. So hopefully it stays there.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So what do you think about La Creole? Make some noise. I want to give a big shout out to Patterson and his amazing staff for giving us this great opportunity. And I also want to say that September 18th is a first for me, and you're all invited to my very first solo concert called Renaissance, which means rebirth in French. And it's myself and DJ Ron John, where I'm going to be performing 12 old school R&B tracks and a couple of my own songs. So I hope you can come out and make it. It's going to be a really stellar night. So hopefully I'll see you September 18th. Part of the proceeds will be going to Help Fight Ebola campaign. Good friends of mine, and I always want to help out in that way. So we have an incredible show for you tonight. We have people in the community doing great things, so you don't want to go anywhere. You're here live at the Nikki Clarke Show, La Creole. Come right back.
The Nikki Clarke Show, transforming lives one story at a time. If you would like to be a guest or become a part of our live studio audience or even to become a sponsor, just go to www.nikkiclarkenetwork.com.
Feel like
Transforming lives one story at a time. If you would like to be a guest or become a part of our live studio audience or even to become a sponsor, just go to www.nikkiclarkenetwork.com.